we have seen in fluid dynamics, Navier-Stokes equation and Reynolds transport theorem. So, what we are going to do is we are going to apply all the concepts of Reynolds transport theorem, Navier-Stokes equation, conservation of mass, conservation of momentum and conservation of energy along with Bernoulli's equation in application of solving problems on bends in pipe. So let us consider a problem which states that a converging pipe with its center line in horizontal plane changes its direction of pipeline by 60 degrees in a clockwise direction. Now this is important because the previous problems which we did was not clockwise. Now, they were anti-clockwise direction and reduces diameter from 30 centimeters to 20 centimeters. So over here this is D1 at the inlet and this is D2. 30 centimeters to 20 centimeters in the direction of the flow. So if the pressure at the inlet, so that is the inlet pressure is given to you, that is 140 kilo Newton per meter, and the flow through the pipe is 0.1 meter cube per second. We have to determine the magnitude and direction of force on the bend due to the moving water. So these all things are given to you in the problem, that is the pressure at the inlet, the initial diameter, the final diameter, as well as the flow rate in the pipe. So let us write down the things which we know. The important part, it is given to us as a clockwise 60 degrees. So let us write down the data which we know. So first data which we know, that is D1 is equals to 30 centimeters. So this is 30 into 10 raised to minus 2, or rather 0.3 meters. Second data which we know, that is D2 is equals to 20 centimeters. So 20 to the 10 to power minus 2, so 0.2 meters. The third thing which we know, that is the flow rate, which is given to us as 0.1 meter cube per second. The fourth thing given to us as pressure at the inlet is 140 kilopascal. So this is 140 into 10 to power 3 Newton per meter square. And the important thing is given to you, theta is equals to minus 60 degree, that is it rotates in a clockwise direction. So now using this data, let us draw the diagram which is for this problem. Let us draw the diagram. So first of all, it is a converging problem, so that means the initial diameter of the pipe is going to be very large. As it goes, it should be rotated clockwise, so it is rotated clockwise, and the final diameter is going to reduce. So over here this is section 1-1, and over here this is section 2-2. The pressure acting at section 1-1 is P1, and the force will be equals to P1 into A1. The pressure acting at section 2 is P2, and the force due to this pressure is equals to P2 A2. Next, the velocity will be traveling through section 1-1 at velocity V1, and the velocity will be traveling at a velocity V2 at the outlet. We'll note that if this is horizontal, the angle it makes with the horizontal is 60 degree but in the clockwise direction. Next, which things we know, that is the diameter at the inlet. Diameter at the inlet is 0.3, and the diameter at the outlet D2 is equals to 0.2 meters. Now, to evaluate this force analysis on the bend, we need to know, first of all, the pressure at the inlet, which we know, the pressure at the outlet, which is unknown, the velocity at the inlet, and the velocity at the outlet. So let us calculate first the velocities at the inlet and outlet, since we know what is the diameter at the inlet as well as the outlet and the flow rate through that entire bend pipe. So now let us calculate what is the velocity at the inlet. So for that, first we need to calculate area A1, that is pi by 4 into D1 square or small capital D1 square. So this will give us pi by 4 into 0.3 square. This is 0.07068 meters square. The area A2 is equals to pi by 4 into D2 square. This is pi by 4 into 0.2 square. That comes out to be 0.0314 meter square. So areas are calculated. Now let us calculate velocities. Velocities and area are related. V1 is equals to Q upon A1. So this is 0.1 upon A1 is 0.07068. On dividing this, 1.415 meters per second. Next, V2 is equals to Q upon A2, that is 0.1 upon 0.0314, which comes out to be 3.183 meter per second. So now we have evaluated values of V1, V2, that is velocities at the inlet and outlet. Now what we have to calculate is the pressure at the outlet. For that, we have to apply what is Bernoulli's equation. So let us apply Bernoulli's equation. Bernoulli's equation states that that is P1 upon rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equals to P2 upon rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. Now here the head loss will be also considering, but since the head loss is not mentioned and we are not in real fluid flow, we are in ideal fluid flow, that is fluid dynamics, the head loss due to head loss will be zero since we are considering the fluid as to be an ideal fluid. Also there is negligible head loss between potential energy head loss between Z1 and Z2, that is between the inlet and the outlet. So both of them are equal, they will cancel out each other. So now let us evaluate the value of P2 from this equation. So let us substitute P1 as given as 140 into 10 to power 3 rho, let us consider that as water, into 9.81 plus velocity, which is 1.145 the whole square, 2 into 9.81 is equals to P2 upon 1000 into 9.81 plus V2, which is given to us as 3.183 square by 2 into 9.81. So now the pressure over here, which gives us as 135.94 kilonewton per meter square or into 10 to power 3. So we have evaluated the pressure at the outlet. We know pressure at the inlet. Now we have necessary data for solving this problem. Now what we are going to do, we are going to draw a master diagram. So for drawing a master diagram, we need to have four things. First, we need to have a force. Next thing, we need to have velocity. The third thing we need to have is inlet and outlet. So let us divide this into four domains for force and velocity at inlet, outlet. Now let us go back to the diagram which we had drawn. So the force at the outlet, from our previous diagram, we know that this is this will go in the second quadrant, that is P2A2, the arrow is going in the second quadrant. So let us draw this in the second quadrant, that is P2A2. Now this is inclined at an angle of 60 degrees to horizontal, hence its horizontal component is P2A2 cos of 60, and its vertical component will be P2A2 sine of 60 degrees. Now similarly, the velocity component in the horizontal direction is V1, and the velocity component at the outlet from our previous diagram, that goes in the fourth quadrant. So we'll draw that, which is inclined at an angle of 60 degrees and going in the fourth quadrant. So this is going in fourth quadrant, inclined at an angle of 60 degree. So this is a V2. So this is V2 cos 60, and this is a V2 sine of 60 degrees. So we have calculated this entire part. So now the only thing which is remaining is applying the equations of motions. So now we know that what is summation of fx equals to, we know that summation of fx will be equals to rho into q, final velocity along x direction, minus initial velocity along x direction. So this is equals to 4fy plus, let us write down the forces along x direction. So the first force along x direction is P1A1, which is going towards right. The second force is P2A2 cos theta, which is going towards left. So let us write down this. So this is a P1A1 minus of P2A2 cos of 60 degrees, which is equals to rho into flow rate into final velocities at the outlet. The final velocity at the outlet along x direction is V2 cos 60, initial velocity along x direction is V1. So let us write down that is final minus initial. So this will be equals to V2 cos of 60 minus V1. So let us evaluate the individual values. So fx plus P1 is 140 into 10 to power 3. The area of cross section, which we have area of cross section we have calculated earlier. So that was equals to 0.07063 minus of P2. P2 is 135.94 into 10 to power 3 into A2, which we had calculated. This is 0.0314, which is equals to rho, that is 1000, into Q, that we had calculated Q. We had a value of Q, that is 0.1. V2, which we had previously calculated as 3.183 cos of 60, minus V1 had the value of 1.145. So now by combining all this, we'll get value of fx as minus of 7.743 kilonewton. So that is 7.743 kilonewton, which is going towards left, that is value of fx. So in our diagram also, we had to specify one thing, that is the sign convention along x direction will be right side positive, left side will be negative, upwards will be positive and downwards will be negative for y directions. Now let us calculate the same thing for y direction. So to evaluate this same thing for y direction, let us write down this part as summation of fy is equals to rho into q vy minus uy. So this is fy now plus force on the bend. Now let us calculate all the forces which is acting in y direction from our master diagram. So in our master diagram, along y direction along inlet there is no force, so P1A1 component won't be there, but you will have P2A2 components, that is P2A2 sine of 60 degrees, rather it is going upwards, hence it is positive. So this is plus P2A2 sine of 60 is equals to rho into q into vy. Vy, that is final velocity along y direction, which is going downwards, hence it will be negative. But the initial velocity along y direction is not there, in y direction is not there. So hence we'll substitute the value as V2 will substitute the value as V2 sine of 60 degree, but it will be negative because it is going downwards. So let us substitute all the values. This P2 came out to be 135.73 into 10 to power 3. A2 was 0.0314 is equals to 1000 into 0.1, which was given to us, and V2 had the value of 3.183, a negative of 3.183 into sine of 60. So on evaluating this, Fy comes out to be minus of 3.973 kilonewton. So this value Fy is equals to positive 3.973 kilonewton, which is going downwards. So now that it is just matter of time to calculate the resultant of both the forces along x direction and along y direction. So let us calculate this. So our summation of x was towards left, summation of Fy is also downwards. So this is a sum Fy, this is Fx, and the angle resultant over here. So now from the diagram itself we can conclude that the resultant will go in the third quadrant. So now R will be equals to square root of Fx square plus Fy square, which is equals to 8.703 kilonewton, and theta is a 27, that is negative positive 27.16 degrees. So here this will be calculated anti-clockwise. So theta was 27.16, and hence it will go in third quadrant. So now this was a problem in which the bend was 60 degree in the clockwise direction. So the important part over here is to note that when we calculate the velocities, as well as when we evaluate rather the direction of velocities and the direction of forces, the sign of those components should be always considered. So here also we had considered the sign convention of velocity components and the force components, whether it is positive or negative depending on the direction, we had to substitute those values. So sign convention also we have to take into consideration. So I hope you have understood how we have calculated the problem using the principle of conservation of momentum, conservation of energy, and conservation of mass. Thank you.